What was the other thing he said? I forgot. Now
taking me to the apartment, but that's
okay. Yeah. No, he didn't say that. That wasn't him. That was the other guy.
That was him.
Saying that they no.
Oh, him. MJ.
Jesus
oh,
Christ. You're confused.
This is Dr. Damages.
Thank you. Welcome to the show. My name is Dr. Damages. We are coming to you from the greatest city in the world.
New York.
Yes. New York City is so great that nobody was murdered last weekend in New York City.
Wow.
Yes. This is the first time something like this happened in a very long time. It shows you that Mayor Bloomberg's plan to tax bullets by 1,000% is working. Simply put, nobody did something that it's worth spending $40 on a bullet for them.
Wow,
that's yeah, $40. I tell you, we are getting somewhere. Talking about getting somewhere, the U.S. government shutdown is finally over.
About time.
Yeah, it's over. Yeah, many people around the world are confused about how the whole thing was resolved. Yeah, forget about what you saw on TV. What happened is this. Once the Confederates stood at the White House gate and waved that dreadful flag, Obama got the message. Watch.
And to demand that this president leave town. To get out. To put the Quran down. To get up off his knees. And to figuratively come up with his hands out.
We demand that Obama put the Quran down, get off his knees, and simply come out with his hands up.
Wow.
That was it. They said Obama should drop the Quran, and he did. He simply dropped it and surrendered. And American nutcases regained their senses.
Wow.
Yeah. Isn't America the greatest democracy in the history of mankind? How did they say that again? Remind me. How did they say that?
God bless America.
Yes. God bless America and no
nowhere
place else.
God bless America and no place else.
Yeah. So, how is our favorite Pope doing?
Good.
This week, Pope Francis said, "I believe in God, not in Catholic God."
What?
No. I will calm down. What is wrong with this Pope, Seth?
Eh?
It's like saying, "I believe in Allah, not in Islamic Allah."
What?
In fact, Malaysia has just banned non-Muslims from referring to God as Allah.
Oh.
I like this Pope, but I suspect that he is not Catholic. To prove my point, the Vatican this week misspelled Jesus on Pope Francis' commemorative coins.
Wow.
Now, how can you walk in the Vatican and misspell Jesus? Eh? It's like saying that you walk in Aso Rock and you misspell patience. That's it. I am now 100% sure that this Pope is not Catholic. But that's okay. Talking about misplaced people, last week we showed you where Nigeria's Minister of Aviation, Stella Oduah, was saying that air crashes are acts of God.
We do not pray for accidents, but it's inevitable. But all we do is to do everything to ensure that we do not have accidents. But it's an act of God.
But as human beings, we need to protect ourselves, even when death is inevitable. Now, as expected, the minister is also doing the same thing. This week, it was revealed that she arm-twisted an agency under her ministry to buy her 2 armored-proofed BMW cars.
Whoa!
2 for 1.6 million.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Whoa.
She has good reason to do that. Good reasons.
What reason?
She said that when you fight people you know are on drugs, you will need to protect yourself against the inevitable. But seriously, in this country, a country like this.
Like most of the 1,000 or so scavengers, Eric doesn't just work on the dump. During the week, he sleeps here too. in a house which he made for himself, from things he found lying around.
This is our cutting.
This is where I hung out.
Where does a Nigerian government official find the butts to sit in a $800,000 car?
I wonder.
Why millions of Nigerians live on less than $2 a day? Is her butt made of gold? Not even Obama's car is worth that much.
Yes, sir.
Now, we check with President Jonathan to see what he thinks about this issue with Stella. Watch.
Corruption is almost in everywhere. But so issue of winning war, people sometimes people take common stealing as corruption.
Yeah, corruption is almost in everywhere. Sometimes people take common stealing as corruption. So $800,000 for one car is common stealing. It's not corruption.
Wow.
You know, I don't trust Nigeria's opposition party, the APC. One of their leaders, Mr. Bola Tinubu, disappeared recently. The news report we were getting was that he came to America to fix his knees. I said to myself, why would Tinubu need knee surgery? Is he preparing to run the marathon? I sensed that something else was going on. So I sent out my crack reporters to go and find Tinubu. You know, as the boss of the APC mafia family, that's what they are, I didn't see anyhow how somebody can shatter his knees. So my crack reporters came back with this video of Tinubu walking out. Watch.
Do you want to say anything?
No.
Before we could air this episode, Tinubu came back to Nigeria. He landed and immediately he heated up the political scene. Listen to him.
How many level of deception? And these people, they are not even smart at a public deception as strategy.
No, he did not say that. Really? He said that Jonathan's people are not smart at public deception as a strategy. Now, Tinubu went on to call President Jonathan's national conference plan insincere. Of course, President Jonathan's attack dog, attack lion, don't you know, Kupe, immediately jumped at Tinubu saying that Tinubu is ignorant and mischievous. For me, I know about the ignorance part, but mischievous? Nah. They don't teach mischievousness at Chicago University. And no matter how much you smoke weed, you don't get to be mischievous. The other APC leader, General Buhari, showed up all of a sudden at the house of the Archbishop of Canterbury the other day. After the meeting, he said to the media that he was heading to Pope Francis' bedroom nest. He said that by the time he returns to Nigeria, that Boko Haram spirit that the media seem to see whenever he's around, hanging on his head, that he will vanish. Talking about people vanishing. In Anambra State, there are a few days before the election for governor, and it's heating up. The major candidates are throwing jabs at each other. Bow, bow. I'm talking about those that could speak English. Not this one. Ask why he wanted to return to governor's office. Dr. Chris Ngige said, and I quote, "Obi is a boy, Ngige is a man." I'm not kidding. Wow. Don't be disappointed. We are actually getting somewhere. This is an improvement. It used to be that Obi is a girl, Ngige is a boy. And I think Obi may still be a girl. I don't quote me, you know. I told you that things are looking up. The militants are not just going to the university. They are starting their own universities. Did you hear that Asare Dokubo opened his own university?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. I'm not making it up. Listen to the man.
King Amakri African University. We are awarding only diploma now.
by September, inshallah, next September, this university will start.
Wow. Yes, yes. Folks, anytime you don't see me on this show anymore, just know that I have gone to Asare Dokubo's University to study diplomacy. Wow. I want my own diploma in diplomacy. And please, pray for me. In entertainment news, a Nollywood model and actor, Soji Bankole, said that while he was changing his clothes backstage at a show, a lady came and held his thing. He said that he begged the lady to leave his thing. Now, here comes another Niger man showing off. Eh? According to Bankole, the lady says, kiss me. I won't leave it if you don't kiss me. Terrible. The same thing happens to me here all the time. But you don't see me bragging, you know, about it. I always say to the ladies, oh, that end, while I walk with the other end. Now, here are the news making headlines across Nigeria this week. Nigeria in deep financial crisis, says Governor Adam Oshomole. Hey. This man, you be like, say you know like your job, eh? Don't you know that you are pissing off Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala? She might fire you. Don't talk bad thing about the economy, it pisses her off. 64 million Nigerians are mentally ill, says Tribune newspaper.
What?
64 million. Do you know what the rest are doing? The rest are on the sideline playing the gong for them. And they are dancing. Anyway, Onisha deportees slam 1 billion naira suit against Lagos state government. I hate to be a party pooper, but I guess these deportees, they've been away from Lagos for too long. Mm. Eh? That money is not enough for a night at the tallest hotel in West Africa, which is now in Lagos. It's not enough. Mm. Ask for more. University College performs first open heart surgery. Wow. Congrats. Yeah. Yeah, the first one. Do you know what the surgeons found in when they opened the heart? They found that the Nigerian heart is not so smart. The heart is not so smart. You know, you don't know the song. You guys are too young. Anyway. For £1 million, United Kingdom is sending back 537 Nigerian prisoners. Wow. So does that mean that Ibori is coming back? You know, just when you think that Mr. Dele is making waves in Lagos, wait until the Londoners come back. Hmm. Yes. EFCC broke, can't pay lawyers.
What?
I know that. I guess that is why our Mustafa wants to do the job for free. Call off strike. Sultan begs ASUU and doctors. Sultan, what happened, man? What happened? In the olden days, presidents, they begged the Sultan. Now the Sultan begs people like doctors and ASUU. What happened? God. Senate President, Speaker, reject 3 billion naira official house. Wow, 3 billion, they rejected it. Wow. Can they donate it to Majek Fashek and the Onesha deportees? They need it. New Abuja city gates to gulp 64 billion naira. They are going to use 64 billion to build this gate.
Wow.
Now, Prophet TV Joshua says that even the gate to heaven was not that expensive. And he should know, you know, he's been there. I would love to have Genevieve as my wife, says the band. Hey, yeah. I guess when everything else fails, you propose via the social media. I love Genevieve. I love Omotola.
I like Genevieve.
It's time for you, huh?
You know. Yeah.
Okay, sorry. Okay, do we have emails today?
Of course, doctor.
All right, let's hear them.
Okay, our first email is from Hajara. She writes, Dear Dr. Damages,
What does good luck Jonathan mean by making the statement to Obama? If you want to fix the world, you have to fix Africa. And for you to fix Africa, you have to fix Nigeria. Please factorize and expand the above statements.
Hajara, look, the president has no idea what he was talking about. He was just reciting the script that Ruben Abati gave him. Did you notice that immediately he went off the script, he became inaudible? Watch it again.
And I will say that for you to fix the world, you must fix Africa. And for you to fix Africa, you have to fix Nigeria. And if you don't fix Nigeria, then you lose it. You must fix Nigeria because that is the highest concentration of blacks.
Next.
Our second email is from Kings in Canada. He writes, "Dear Doctor, I am one of the numerous viewers of your show. I do really enjoy it because there's never a dull moment. Continue the good work by exposing those people in our country who has made up their mind to forever be enemy of progress to that country. More grease to your elbow. Please, I want you to grant me a favor. Do not stop talking about the Agbo killing and all thieves. Please expose the cabal behind these all thieves. I believe Jonathan knows them, but refuses to attack them. Let me tell you a secret. People are counting on you with what you're doing to change our Nigeria. There are so many people interested in your show, counting on it to be the agent of change to the country. God bless you, and I enjoyed the show as well."
Oh, thank you so much, Kings. Thank you so much. But isn't it too much pressure on one man and his tomato juice, eh? To put all this weight on us to change that rotten society. I think everyone must get involved. You know, if you need your own tomato juice, let me know. We can mail one to you. Next.
Our third email is from Abiola in Qatar. He writes, "Hi, my powerful Dr. Damages. My question is very simple. I want to become an activist like you guys. I have the potential, but lack encouragement and no idea of how to go about it. I really love your show and I appreciate your personality. Please help me out. I know I can do it, but I do not know how to start."
Ah, no problem, Abiola. No, it's very easy. Just get a camera, turn it on yourself and start talking. Even when you're sitting in the toilet. You know what I mean? It can change the world. Watch.
Sitting in the toilet. Stupid Buhari. Sitting in the toilet. Stupid Namechi.
Stupid Buhari. Sitting in the toilet. All right. Next.
Our fourth email is from Mohammed in Abuja. He writes, "Hello. I just saw your show and it was very hilarious. I came about the show when one of my friends was watching it on YouTube and was laughing. I said, let me try and watch it and get to know what it's all about. And found out that the show is hilarious with serious jokes, so keep it up. I hope you will get cash from this because that's what our comedians in Nigeria are doing and getting serious cash with these jokes. Wish you all the best." I told what? You.
Does he know how that can happen? Mohammed, thank you so much.
Eh? I told you.
But about getting cash, eh? Me and Tomato Joss, we have given up on that. It's only keeping it real that gets the cash and the designer
money.
Clothes and
she
everything. Advertisers are so scared of being seen near us.
Mm-hmm.
Because the government of Nigeria will deal with them if they advertise with us. Eh? Mm-hmm. Even our fans, when they write, they use fake names out of fear.
Mm-hmm.
But that's all right, you know. If our viewers are happy, we are happy. Cash or no cash. Now, let the Nigerian comedians, let them suck up to power and continue on in their ways. On the day of judgment, we shall see. Next.
Our fifth email is from Oluwatosin in Nigeria. He writes, "Hello, good doctor. I'm a first-time writer, but I'm all episode watcher." Yeah, that's a first.
Mm.
"I hope you get to read out my email. I must say, doc, that your last episode was probably the best of them all."
Thank you.
"I had to go check all the prominent people that had rang the New York City bell. And I found out that even the Smurfs and Hello Kitty had rung the bell too. Congratulations to GEJ. I think now we know just how privileged GEJ and Nigeria is that our president rang the bell. It's so sad that Nigeria is tottering on the brink of collapse and the people are urging it on. Anyway, thank you for the great job. Saturday nights come alive when Dr. Damages come on here. Regards to the nurse. P.S. Did you notice that Jamaic asked for his shoes after the spiritual gymnastics?"
Thank you, Oluwa Tosin. Thank you so much. You see, what we tell people is that you can fool some people sometimes. And you can fool some people all the time. But you can't fool all the people all the time. About Jimmy Ike, you know, he also left his false teeth there. We picked it up. Next.
You're bad. Our fifth email is from Franklin in Spain. He writes, I'm a regular listener to your TV in Jackery Show. I'm happy for having such a bold, fearless, and candid Nigerian like you in Tomato Joss. And I will be more happy if you can diagnose these disturbing questions with me. One, why is it that President Goodluck Jonathan always seems to be dominated by fearfulness in most times while addressing the public and the media as well? Number two, will you, Dr. Damages, stop saying all these odds you knew about Goodluck Jonathan if he can send a carton of $1 million shut up bribe for you like like he did to, I don't know what's his name?
Uwazulike,
him. Number three, I haven't for one day heard you criticizing our so-called pastors and their general overseers who turn as fishers of wealth and other material values. Do you, Dr. Damages, have a brother among them?
Hey, still writing?
He's still writing, no. He said, I can only reveal these secrets only if you can send your tomato juice to interview me in my private apartment. Please, never mind about her bills. I will take care of it myself.
Wow. Franklin, thank you so much for writing, and I'm happy that you watch. Let me tell you, Jonathan is afraid of the media because they might ask him to show his PhD thesis. And, you know, that is copy and paste, copy and pasting, you know. That's why. Now, you talked about me getting $1 million and selling myself because of that. Obviously, you have not seen $1 million. Because if you have, you know that they don't carry dollars in cartons. It's only your naira that they carry in cartons. As for not criticizing pastors, maybe you're confusing me with keeping it real. My job here is to criticize pastors. And if not just for my cousin Azoka, all Catholics, they don't watch my show anymore. Deeper Life Church people, they don't watch my show. Winners Chapel, none. Redeemed Christian Church, none. But it's okay. We keep saying the truth. Listen, my man, Franklin, if you want Tomato Joss's phone number, ask me in a good way, kind way. Eh? Don't use corner way to try to get a number from me. Eh? Be kind. You just, yeah. And it's 212-785-5637. Yeah. Next.
Our seventh email is from Da Exo in Italy. He writes, do you remember MJ's former physician, Dr. Comrade Mori, who was sentenced to 4 years in prison? If care isn't taken, the same thing will happen to you for damaging the medulla oblongata of our bad luck president. However, to be sincere, I am addicted to your show and Adiola's keeping it real, more than a morning coffee. Ooh. Because I never stop smiling, just like you sitting beside your beautiful parrot tomato juice. Pick up my guy. He called me a parrot.
But it's a beautiful one, yeah. So, Da Exo, thank you so much for writing. You know, unlike Michael Jackson's doctor, I have my malpractice insurance. And I know good lawyers in New York City, so nothing spoiled. In fact, I was supposed to do another surgery on the president soon. But because of this Stella Oduah thing, you know, we have to delay it. You understand? What was the other thing he said? I forgot. Now,
taking me to the apartment, but that's
okay, yeah. No, he didn't say that. That wasn't him. That was the other guy.
It was him.
Saying that they... No, not
him. MJ.
Jesus
oh.
Christ. You're confused. Okay.
Adiola, he likes your show.
Yeah, I know.
The president's medulla oblongata.
Okay. That's all the time we have for emails. Please keep sending your emails to drdamages@gmail.com. Now, this is my concern for today. It's taken from the book of Anonymous, chapter 1, verse 23. And it says, be kind to those you meet on your way up, because you will meet them on your way back down. Until next week, I diagnose.
You heal yourself!
Now that you have a show, you have to be kind to people like us because you're going to meet us when you're coming down.
I won't come down.
You're coming down.
But tell
you. Are going
tell
down.
Tell your fans to stop calling me.
You're coming down.